I think a lot of times in relationship, we miss out on beautiful things because we're just afraid. Fear and love cannot coexist.
I was 20 when we met.
20, uh-huh.
And I was a producer and a musician working for Death Row Records at the time. I was broke because I didn't understand how money works. I would make money and just like spend it on tennis shoes and rims and stuff. I didn't know what to, I was 20, so. And when I met her, she was already wife. Like she had already, she had the wife.
Wes, say it one more time, boo.
I would drive my raggedy Toyota Tercel. You had an old school BMW, and we would just drive and just be with each other all of the time. It was like once we started hanging, we never stopped. I think a lot of times in relationship, we miss out on beautiful things because we're just afraid. Fear and love cannot coexist. Perfect love casts out all fear. So because I knew the love that I felt for him was where I was like, I'm gonna say it, and Lord, if this is ordained and designed by you, it's gonna be okay. And our words have power. Mm-hmm. You can't be happily married and you're in your home, but then when you're with your girlfriends or in your own time, oh, I hope it doesn't fall apart. You've just given life to something that could kill your relationship.
Right.
He better not. I better not. Ooh, I hope I don't. Like all these negative words that we use about our own relationships, you're breathing life into death over your own life.
Right.
So you have to watch your words. You can be careful and you can be wise and get counseling and all that good stuff, but a lot of times we are our worst enemy and we don't even realize it because of what we say.
Before I came home and told my wife, listen, baby, this and this happened. I cheated. I slept with this girl. I had a conversation with my pastor and he said, well, are you going to tell her? I said, yeah, I'm going to tell her because we're such good friends that she may not leave me. He said, well, I don't know about that. I am ashamed because I almost derailed my entire family, you know, and so no man wants to just bring that up. We talk about it, we went through it. I just don't want to hear about it no more. But now I'm open to talking about it when I feel like it's going to help somebody get through it. Own it. Be honest, brutally honest with each other about the why. Because if you don't know why you did it, then you'll do it again. It wasn't like we weren't having sex. It wasn't like I was unhappy. I was selfish. That's why this happened. I don't care what her role is. She could have withheld sex for 30 days, 3 months. She still didn't put a gun to my head and make me step outside my marriage. You know what I'm saying? I made that choice. The vows say, till death do us part. Why? Because it takes that long to really completely love somebody. It takes a lifetime. And I'm committed for a lifetime. So that's why it's so beautiful.